When you're at a restaurant and you're about to order your meal, you usually think of two things: what you're gonna get or how much it's gonna cost you. Many people forget one important factor when they're ordering their food. How is the food going to affect their body later on? Today I'm gonna be talking about the impact of food consumption on children, adults, and tips to help ensure a healthier diet. Children rely on their parents for everything, especially food. But since family dynamics have changed and both parents are typically working now and they're working longer hours, they're unable to make home-cooked meals for their children. And because of this, they're relying on fast food more. Now, fast food is easy and convenient, but it's not always the best answer for children's meals. Children aren't getting as much nutrients as they need, and they're also getting overfed. Because parents are also working longer hours, they're sending their kids to daycares and home cares. 31% of preschool-age kids are being sent to home cares, and this can include grandparents, aunts, uncles, other family, and friends. 41% of all preschool-age kids are being sent to daycares. Now, you might be wondering, why is this such a big deal? This is a big deal because parents aren't able to watch the intake of food that their children is getting, and they're also not able to give them the right nutrients that they need. Now, low-income families aren't able to provide for their children the nutrients that they need because they can't afford the food. And because of this, they're just trying to feed their kids any kind of food that they can, whether it's good or bad. And this is a big problem because 35% of all American children are obese. And when they're learning obesity or learning bad habits at a young age, their obesity can follow them to adulthood. And because of this, one in every three American adults are obese. And obesity is really dangerous and it can cause many diseases. A couple examples is cardiovascular disease, hypertension, and diabetes. Cardiovascular disease is caused when you eat too many saturated fats, too many red meats, and you eat full fat dairy products. And there's also, you aren't exercising well and you're not eating a healthy diet. Cardiovascular disease affects your renal vein and it's a plaque buildup and it can cause a heart attack and it can be very lethal. Hypertension is caused by eating too much salt and not sticking with the diet. This is caused by high blood pressure and it can cause a stroke, which can also be very lethal. Diabetes is caused by not eating or not reducing your sugar levels, eating too many carbs, and eating too many fried foods. Diabetes can cause heart disease or stroke, and this is caused by your cells not being able to produce enough insulin to your body, and it is less sensitive, and it hurts your pancreas. But if you don't want those diseases, here are some tips to help ensure a healthy diet. You want to make sure you're eating the right amount of fruits, vegetables, grains, milk, protein. You want to make sure your fruits are whole fruits. You vary your vegetables and you switch them out with other vegetables. You want to move away from the fat, from your fat with milk, and you want to move to low fat or fat-free milk. You want to make sure that half of your grains are whole grains, and you want to vary your protein, so different meats, adding different other protein products as well, such as like beans and nuts and corn. You also want to cut back on sugary products, and you also want to stay away from fats. If you want to know exactly how much you should be eating, you can check your BMI or your BASMati. Your BMI. There's many websites that are reliable to check it. You just plug in your height and your weight, and you can also check with your doctors as well. So the next time that you're thinking about what you're going to eat for your next meal, Think about the impact that the food's going to have on your body. Today I talked to you about the impact of food consumption on children, adults, and tips to ensure a healthier diet. Thank you.